I am Takilam Mibol Singh, lecturer in geography. I am teaching geography in class 11 and 12 standard. For today, let me discuss a new topic, population composition or demographic structure. By population composition, we mean all those population characteristics or all the characteristics of human population which are measurable and also helpful in comparing or distinguishing one group of population from other group of peoples. It includes age composition, sex, literacy, place of residence, and human occupation. The study of population composition is very important for setting a future agenda of development. Let us take the first composition, that is sex composition. Sex composition of the population may be defined or may be measured by a ratio, what we call sex ratio. In fact, sex ratio refers to the number of male or female per thousand of female or male. It is very interesting to note here, if sex ratio is expressed male population, measurement is to be made per thousand of female. In other words, sex ratio is measure female population, the measurement is made per thousands of males. Accordingly, there are two types of sex ratio. That the first one, sex ratio indicates male population. Another is sex ratio indicates the female population. Based on the Pareto recording, sex ratio has of three types. The first one is primary sex ratio, the second secondary sex ratio, the third one tertiary sex ratio. Primary sex ratio indicates the number of male or female population at the time of conception. Secondary sex ratio indicates the number of male or female population at the time of birth. The tertiary sex ratio indicates the number of either male or female population at the time of enumeration. Yes, these are the important types of sex ratio we need to discuss so far. Next, come to global variation of sex ratio. Globally, there is a great variation of sex ratio all over the world. Sex ratio generally, or in most countries in the world, sex ratio is expressed or measured in terms of female population, except in USA. Generally in Asia, the sex ratio is very, very low. In those countries where gender discrimination is quite pronounced, in that countries or in that society, female feticide, female infanticide, domestic violence are common practices. Therefore, in such society or in that countries, there is the low sex ratio, means the number of male population is more than the number of female population. Thus, sex ratio or low sex ratio indicates low socioeconomic status of the people. On other countries, on other hands, in European countries, there is the sex ratio is very, very high, showing that higher socioeconomic development amongst the female population. These are the important points that we need to study, we need to comprehend about the sex composition all over the world. There are certain reasons behind the sex ratio in India. It is because of high mortality rate among the female population. It is due to predominance of male in Indian society. There's one more point is that is the domestic violence against women. These are the important points we need to understand about the sex ratio. Next come to the another demographic structure, what we call that is age composition. And by age composition, we know that the population belong to different age group. We know that population of any country of the world under study consists of the people belong to different age group, starting from 0 age up to 100 and above. It is very difficult to study. It's in every age group in any population of the world or in any population of the country, of the state. Therefore, the census of different countries of the world, including in our state, in our country, India, has categorized age group of age composition of the population into three broad age groups. The first one is, that is youth or children. The second is adult. The third one is, that is aged or old. The youth age group are those population that belong the age group 0 to 14 years of age. The adult population belong to 15 to 59 years of age. The aged or old age group are those section or segment of population that belong to age group 60 and above. The first and third age group, the first one is youth, the last one is aged, are collectively known as dependent population. While the second one is very important age group, that is called working age group. This particular section of the population, what we call working population, is very important because they have a certain characteristics which are not available to other age group. They are economically productive, biologically reproductive, socially they are more mobile. If the economic strength of a country, of a nation, depends heavily on the number or the proportion of working age group, they are economically active population. They are active in the sense that they can participate in any economically gainful work during a year. Therefore, the economic, they are the income earner. You know, the economic strength of the nation depend on the percentage share of this age group. There is a great variation amongst all over the world, amongst different countries of the world, based on their age composition. Normally, age composition also reflects socioeconomic status of the country concerned. Socially or economically developed countries are having larger proportion of working age group. Therefore, they have better economic condition due to the predominance of income earner rather than income exhauster or income eater. On contrary, socially or economically less developed countries, there is the preponderance of young age group because there is a high birth rate and the high mortality rate amongst the people of all age group. In countries like in Asia, say for example, the total population of Asia as per census report 2011 is predominated by younger age group because the high birth rate is there on one side. There is the low life expectancy on other side due to high mortality rate. On contrary, in especially developed countries, especially in Western European countries, there is the predominance of elderly population, that is the predominance of working age group due to the low birth rates and less mortality rates in all age group. Therefore, they have better economic condition. These are the important we have to understand regarding the sex composition. So far, our India is concerned. The census of India has defined working population or workers as workers are those sections of the population that belong to that is the second age group and also are capable of participating in any economically productive work in the year. There are three types of workers. They are, that is the men workers, number two, marginal workers, number three, yes, non-workers. Men workers are those workers or the those population belong to age group of 15 to 59 years. and also participate in any economically gainful work not less than 183 days in a year. Marginal worker, those section of the population belong to the age group of 15 to 59 years and also participated in any economically gainful work less than 6 months or 183 days in a year. Non-workers are nothing but they are belong to the workers, belong to the working age group. By virtue of their age, makhoygi chahi duna maram oraga hairba chahi working age group ki chahi ski manung chanba sahi trauma dagina yankhai mapan bhuki marakta legadaba tawbadabo makhoydi chahi yamgi manung da no mphau paisa phangba thabak sudriba like those students yes who are reading in class 11 12 and above, even graduates. Again, the Census of India has also used a new term that is called participation rate. The term participation rate refers to the number of workers, both men and marginal workers, of the total population of the country and also expressed by percentage. Participation rate can be calculated separately for male and female. But in India, participation rate has been increasing slowly in the last few decades. It shows that there is a greater development for employment opportunities in the country and loosening of social stigma attached to the manual workers. That means, but female participation rate in the country is very, very low still in our India. Because of a certain reasons, the past reasons, due to the joint family system is quite prevalent in different part of the country, it makes difficult or it makes little scope for female to participate in any economically productive work. The second reason is female population are deprived of proper education and access. Females are not getting opportunity for participation in earning activities. The third reason, frequent childbirth makes females immobile. The third composition is rural urban population. As we know that population of the world, population of India, the population of Manipur, here I mean world, India and Manipur, as per syllabus prescribed by Council for the student of class 12. We can differentiate this population of these three different units or areas into rural and urban based on the place of their residence. Generally, rural population are those population or those people who are inhabited, who are living in rural environment or villages. On other hand, on the contrary, urban population are those population or people living in urban environment, such as town or cities. There is a great differentiation between rural population and urban population in many respects, say economy, demography, and social structure. As we know that in people in rural population, the primary activities of the people or the economic activities of the rural peoples is agriculture and allied activities. On other side, the main occupation of the people living in urban centers such as town or cities are mainly non-agricultural activities. It may be a secondary, it may be a tertiary, and more quaternary or quinary. In this way, we can differentiate the population of the world, population of India, population of our state Manipur into rural and urban based on the place of residence. But in due course of time, or with the current of time, or with the passage of time, the percentage of urban population goes on increase by a process that is called urbanization. Urbanization means a conversion of rural environment or the rural population to that of urban population or urban environment. Whenever urbanization takes place anywhere in the world, three types of changes take place. The first one is social change. The second is a demographic change. The third one is an economic change. Let me continue a small portion of this class, that is literacy composition. Literacy is a reliable index of economic development of any country of the world. Literacy composition is indicated or is defined by literacy rate. Literacy rate is the number of literate person per 100 of people, and also expressed in percentage of the population above 15 years of age. There are certain factors that decide or that depend literacy rate of the world. The first one is levels of economic development. Number two, levels of urbanization. Number three, socioeconomic status of female. Number four, availability of educational facilities. As we know that literacy rate has a directly related to these four factors, as I just mentioned here. The last composition of population is human occupation. By occupation, we mean economic activities of the people belong to the age group 15 and 59 years. Based on their occupation, we recognize four types of human activities. The first one is primary, the second is secondary, tertiary, and last one is quaternary. Primary activities are nothing but those economic activities of this section of the population that are very much related to their survival. In other words, primary activities are those activities that men perform or men render in order to get primary needs of our life, that is food, cloth, and shelter. Secondary activities are those activities that men engage or men perform or men render to get the secondary needs, means value added products. It includes, yes, manufacturing industry. The last one is tertiary activities. Tertiary activities, actually it is a core activities of any economy. It is actually a service economy, or that activities render or comprises that provide service of different kinds to the people. For today, we are going to close. Thank you.